Utilising the whole catch, and kingfish is one fish you can really do that with. It's literally only the gills and the guts that'll go.
What do you do with the guts and gills?
We've got a fertiliser program that every bit of the fish is used.
Every single bit?
Yeah, every single bit.
I've only ever caught one kingfish, and in the kitchen it is the king. It's one of the best fish you can, raw, cooked. I just love everything about it. So that's my drink today, kingfish.
Get that mackerel down there.
Go for it. Down to the land.
Yeah, that's a kingfish, mate.
Get that.
You've got to get him moving. Get him moving before he gets into the rocks.
Yeah,
lift him with the rod. Lift him with the rod. And wind down. So you wanted to give up on that?
A bit of some drag.
You 40 kilo bitch.
I'm picking your ones a little bit bigger than the ones we've seen so far, mate.
I've had like an adrenaline dump.
It's shaking. An adrenaline dump, mate. And if we land the fish, your body will give you some endorphins. Because that's your body telling you you've done well and you should do it again. I'll get a lip gaff in case I decide I need it.
You're mine, boy.
Yeah, that's a decent one,
mate.
Give it a little. That's a decent one, boy. Stop winding.
Oh, yes.
That's a good.
Whoa!
That's why we stuck with it.
That's what
you wanted, that's what we come for. And that's.
That's cool.
Oh, baby.
Right.
Man, now, I'm shaking.
Under normal circumstances, that's sort of getting into the size range I'd let go.
Yeah.
So why would you put it back at this size?
Just because they're better at breeding, right?
Oh, yeah, okay, so you put back the bigger ones.
Yeah, but we've also got to understand, yeah. Look, you're shaking, mate. There's those endorphins. There's no shade whatsoever. If you want to keep it, as long as we respect the fish by eating the whole thing, head to tail.
Yeah, we're going to eat it, mate.
Okay, we're going to eat it.
Yeah.
Good one, mate. They look amazing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And they taste good, you know, it's the full package, isn't it, really?
I've prepped so many of them, it's just so good to actually catch one, you know?
Feel it, yeah, it is.
You have a better appreciation for
the
food, you know?
Yeah.
And it's not easy.
No, it's not.
These fish come in and you just don't appreciate how hard it is to actually catch them, you know?
Yeah.
So it's awesome to,
it is, mate. Yeah.
To feel the power of it and to pull it in.
Dead right. It makes you have an appreciation of where it comes from as well. That's why so big on utilisation. That's why Carlos is here today, because he's all about that same kaupapa of utilising the whole catch. And kingfish is one fish you can really do that with. It's literally only the gills and the guts that'll go. And even some of the guts, the livers, we can eat as well.
Thank you for the feed.
Yeah.
Now I've got a few tricks how to make a 15 kilo one look like a 20 kilo one.
All right. Do you need to hold about?
All in the angles.
All in the angles. Right,
okay,
now let's
Jimmy time.
Pick a Jimmy, yep. So that's up inside the spine now. Okay, and then we go down the. So you watch his fins as it goes down.
Yeah, that's crazy.
Down inside the spine. That's all the way down now. Okay, so it's gone through and you see it, all his fins have all shut down now.
Yeah.
I'll pull that out. Lay that there. Look at that, it's gone right to the tail.
Wow,
so
it's amazing.
Every nerve's been severed, and that fish will be better eating quality. You can even feel it relax.
Yep.
So we'll just get that on ice now, and that is your Ikijima.
Mate, thank you, that's awesome.
Beautiful bed. Thanks for lunch.
Mate, thank you guys.
Just got to pay it the ultimate respect. Look after it, make it sure it eats good, and it's going to eat real good.
There's a lesson here for our commercial guys, because when the fish is swimming in the ocean, it's 100% quality.
Yeah.
And if the fishermen do this, when they catch it, they can sell it for more.
They can, that's
but
right.
But they don't.
Take less at a higher value.
Yeah.
And it's more abundant.
Yeah.
And when there's more fish, they don't have, instead of having to go 40 miles to catch their fish, they only have to go 20. So, you know, carbon footprint, fuel costs, all sorts.
Yeah.
You know, I've long maintained that New Zealand's got the wrong strategy with our fish.
Yeah.
We're bulk harvesting it and selling it in bulk for a pittance.
Yeah.
You know, like snapper for $4 or $5 a kilo because it's been sold in such bulk.
Yeah.
Well, one of it's classic supply and demand. Let's just say to the rest of the world, guess what? There's only one country in the world that's got New Zealand snapper. It's us, and this is the price.
Yeah.
And yes, they might run off and get a market for cheap fish from somewhere else, but it's all running out and it's not as good. Yeah. And they're going to come back and they're going to pay the price.
Exactly.
And we all do well from it.
Yeah. Beautiful. There I'm stoked. Go. Thank you so much.
No worries, mate. Well done. Yo! And the last piece to the equation, of course, is just a nice salt ice slurry. And once they're slurried and chilled right down, we'll drain the water off and just keep them on salt ice. And that just lets all the juices come off of them once they're slurried down to a very cold temperature, just to firm that flesh up. I was going to say al dente, but that would have made no sense whatsoever. Al dente. Très bon. That's French for it's good.
Behind the scenes, boys, how the magic's made.
Yeah.
That sexy voice.
Oh, you know, there's got to be something in it for the ladies too. So here we are, back where we started, fellas. This is normally the bit where we've got to clean up all the fish, the catch of the day. But don't you worry, I'm not going to have you boys filleting. This is where we just take service to the next level.
Oh, guys, who caught this?
Oh, my. Okay, we're just going to do a quick scrub up, Quinnen, and we'll be up to take a look at you, weave your magic. Yep. See you in a sec. You got to come and have a look at this. This is going to be good. Well, this is where some real magic's going to happen. Dave and Quinton from Kaieka are about to clean up our catch. So a lot of people complain about filleting. Well, because it's such a laborious job, well, look at this happen right in front of us. There you go, there's one fillet. Just while I've been
hang
yarning.
On a sec, slow down, brother. Whoa.
Can I just grab that frame off you, Dave? And I mean, yes, you can fill it fast and you can fill it rough. I challenge anyone to take their time and do it any neater than that. And the beauty of that is, see, the gut cavity hasn't been breached, so there's no gut going onto the fillet. And that's just the first step. Wait till these boys are finished up with this. Okay, go. But we'll stop slowing you down, and now you can really unleash and show us some magic. The attention to detail, eh? What do you do with the guts and gills?
We've got a fertiliser program going out at the Papatua Neke Marae. They're developing organic fertiliser with it. So.
Wow.
So we take it out there and so every bit of the fish is used.
Every single bit?
Yeah, every single bit.
Wow. So even these containers have got a little grill in them, so any moisture comes away from the fillet. People think that fish smell. Fish don't smell. It's the juice that comes off the fish, the bacteria grows in it and dies, and that's what creates a smell. So if you have no juice and you keep it clean and dry, well then there's no smell, and it lasts longer and tastes better. It's perfect. Perfect.
And that's your finished product.
There it is there. Look at that. I've got to give a big shout out to Quinton and Dave. That was incredible. The whole Kaieka program, which let's not forget is backed by a legacy, who are out there championing the rights of recreational fishers and making sure that there's fish in places like the Hauraki Gulf for us all. So if you haven't found out about Legacy, please look it up, legacy.co.nz. I think everyone that goes out on the water and takes some fish should give a little bit back. And Legacy will show you exactly how you can do that. And please don't throw those fish heads and frames away. They're far too good to waste. If you want to get more detail on anything you've seen in this video, you can check out ultimatefishing.tv, where we have step-by-step videos on how to catch kingfish using all kinds of techniques and rigs. And not just kingfish, we've got tips for all kinds of fish.
And I'm out to 8 colours now, which is 80 metres, which is where I'm showing that sign.
And it doesn't stop there. Once you've caught your fish, we have step-by-step videos on how to clean and fillet most common species of fish. And we also show you easy ways to utilise the entire catch and make some surprisingly tasty meals.
And the real special little bit, the fish skin chips.
And you can get it all right now for free at ultimatefishing.tv.